ะผู้คนแต่ละครั้งนี้รู้สึกยังไง
ก็มั่นใจขึ้นเรื่อยๆนะครับเสียงตอบรับดีขึ้นเรื่อยๆจากเดิม
Thai PBS World recently followed Thanathorn Jungroongruangkit, leader of Future Forward Party, on his campaign trail at one of Bangkok's busiest shopping areas known as Krubi Market on Ramathri Road.
ผมยิ่งคิดว่าพรรคอนาคตใหม่ก็จะมีความพร้อมมากขึ้นเท่านั้น
24มีนาคมนะเราจะมีการเลือกตั้งเกิดขึ้น
ขอโทษนะครับผมรบกวนเวลานิดนึงขออนุญาตแนะนำตัวเองนะผมชื่อThanathorn Jungroongruangkit ผมเป็นหัวหน้าพรรคอนาคตใหม่ผมตั้งพรรคนี้ขึ้นมาเพื่ออยากจะเปลี่ยนแปลงผลักดันประเทศไทย
And these reactions from the lunch crowd certainly say a lot about how well he is being received. We are here to change Thailand is Thanathorn's key message. But how is the 41-year-old businessman turned politician with no known political experience going to change Thailand?
86 years of the process of democratization in Thailand, we're still going nowhere. You know, over the past 86 years, we have 13 military coup d'etat in this country. So we want to end this. When we talk about change, be it economic change or political change, I believe that we need to democratize the society. So, we want to put an end to military coup d'etat in Thailand, make military intervention into politics history. That's the change we are talking about.
So it sounds like your idea of changes will be directed mainly at the military establishment.
Not the military alone. When we talk about this group of people, you might want to call it the establishment. You might want to call it the elite. You might want to call them the 1%. You might want to call them, you know, the ruling class. Whatever you might want to call them, I think we mean the same thing. And this group of people, they're not comprised of military alone, but also the senior ranking government officials. We are talking about the capitals, big capitals in Thailand. So I think these people, they form an alliance of the establishment. So when talking about the change, we would like to bring the power from them and spread it back to the people. We want to bring the fruit of the economic development from them and spread them to the people of the lower income.
But there is no denial that you need money, a lot of it, to win elections. How is Future Forward Party going to take the political high road and still expect to win?
And where have you been getting the money to finance the campaign?
Since the beginning of our party, which was on the 3rd of October, so we are 1, 2, 3, about 4 months now, we are able to raise some 70 million Thai baht from the public. So we are very proud of that.
Who are these people who contributed to?
Oh, there's people who contributing. For example, I myself, I contributed to the party to the maximum limit the law allowed. The law allows me to individual to contribute 10 million. So I put my 10 million to the party.
And the rest?
And the rest, we have some people who donated, who gave us 5 million. We have some people gave us like 20 baht, 10 baht, you know, 100 baht. So that's a wide range of people who contribute to our party. All of this money that been given to our party, to the cause of our party, they are unconditional, no condition attached.
So why do you think they would want
they
to
believe
part
in us.
With that big amount
they
of
believe
money?
In our dreams. They have the same dreams. They have the same ideology. So we are very proud of this. Even though we cannot raise, you know, some 600 million like other political parties do, but we managed to raise 60 million from the people and we are proud of that. You know, we are selling shirts like this, t-shirts like this. Other political parties, you don't see them doing. We sell the mugs, shirts, bags, and you know, all other things to raise money.
Thanathorn has been hitting the campaign trail since October. What has he learned that reinforces his belief that he is pushing the right button in appealing to voters who might not even heard of him a few months ago?
The income inequality is real. It's tangible. Everywhere you go, you can feel it. You got people, you know, Khun Somkit Chatusi Pithak, our Deputy Prime Minister. He says every day that the economy is going strong. We have the GDP growth of about 3-4% over the last 3-4 years. When you talk about GDP growth, this number is deceptive in the sense that it says that how big the economy is growing, but it's not telling you who's the wealth going through, right? And it's clear that the last 4 years, the wealth, the growth is growing to the pockets of the rich. 450, people in the 450s list growing their wealth at 12% a year, whereas the people on the streets, their income is getting lower year by year. I think this is very dangerous.